Hey, this is Chris. Hope you're doing well, and welcome to Popcorn Finance, the show where we discuss finance and about the time it takes to make a bag of popcorn. On Monday, Erin Lowry joined me to talk about her new book, Broke Millennial Talks Money, and the awkward situations that we can find ourselves in when we need to talk to our friends about the money issues that we're having. And in this special midweek bonus bag of popcorn, we're going to look at the situation from a different perspective and add a new little wrinkle to what can already be a very awkward and difficult situation, and that is, how do you deal with having these conversations with your friends when you have a significant other involved? So when you have a husband, a wife, a partner, someone else who you're sharing not only your personal life with, but your financial life with, how do you handle this somewhat complicated and difficult situation? So that's what we're going to dive in today. So hope you enjoy this extra bonus conversation. One question or one thought that came to my mind was the kind of like combining of two worlds, like, because you have your, like, your friendship, and then you may have like your significant other, your spouse or your partner. And that changes the dynamic a little bit between how you talk about money and talk about what's going on in your own life, because it's not just your life anymore. So how do you approach talking to maybe friends? Say you have a friend, they're like, yes, I would love to talk to you about money and situations. I've been just looking for the person to talk to about this. But you have someone else at home to think about, and their comfort level with you sharing so much personal information about what you guys are doing. How do you balance that? How do you strike the compromise or safe zone of conversation with a friend when there's someone else involved?
Well, first, I think you need to know what your partner is comfortable with, and that needs to be a conversation between the two of you. I do think it's really important you respect the boundaries that your partner wants for both themselves and for you as a couple. So if there's the two of you, and let's say you both work, and let's say you both have student loan debt, and between the two of you, a little bit of credit card debt. To a degree, I think you have a right to share your personal information with your close friend. So I earn X amount. I have this much in student loan debt. I charged a $2,000 bachelorette party to Tulum to my credit card that I haven't been able to pay off yet. Heyo, call back. So a big part of me wants to say, you get to have the autonomy of your situation. However, that still needs to be a conversation with your partner, particularly if it's a spouse, about, are you comfortable with me sharing those kind of details? Especially something like salary. Is your spouse comfortable with you sharing how much even just you makes? Because let's say that it's a healthy number. Let's say you alone are well into the six figures and your partner works too. Then people are going to start making assumptions about what the two of you together earn. And what does that mean for how you interact with your friendship dynamics? Like, these should all be things that you and your partner need to decide for yourselves. For me personally, I remember when my husband, who I call Peach, when we got married, I, for a long time before we got married, had been public about the fact that he had student loans because he was okay with me talking about the fact that he had student loans, but I never shared the actual number. And as we were going through the debt repayment process, I would publicly say things like, oh, we just paid one off. We just paid off a private loan. Oh, we just paid off a federal loan. And interestingly enough, it wasn't until they were all paid off that all of a sudden he was comfortable with me disclosing the number that existed. But I didn't tell friends. I didn't, like, it wasn't just a public thing. Like, I didn't share that information because it wasn't mine alone to share. Did it impact my life? Sure. Was my name on the loans? No. But it still impacted our marital situation and our actual financial household. And he gets a say too. You know, I talk very openly about having a prenup, but I talk openly about it because he's comfortable with me doing so. I know people who have prenups that do not talk about it publicly. And frankly, if somebody asked them if they had one, I think they would probably lie. And that's not so much just their discomfort. It's about their partner or their spouse as well.
Yeah, I think it is so important to think about, like, the implications of sharing personal information when someone else is involved. Because you're right, they might not be the one who would want to go around and share that information, but you're kind of speaking for them if they're not there.
You are. And even if you're sharing what you consider to be your half, that still lays a certain amount of context clues for your friends who are then probably going to try to fill in some blanks.
Yeah, filling in that narrative again. Like that.
Yep.
They're building a nice little story about you that they may tell to other people that you don't want to have going around.
And what can get awkward is if you're in a friendship dynamic where you always did share, and then you get married, and now you don't share. And that's just something you need to be upfront about. Because I actually write about that in the book, that happened with a friend of mine, where she had asked me a very specific financial question. And I needed more context to the overall financial picture in order to give a response. So I was asking some questions. It was about, like, you know, how much is going to 401k? What's the current student loan balance? And she said, I have to be honest, now that I'm married, I don't feel comfortable sharing all of that information anymore because it's his information too. And I don't think he's comfortable with that. And I was like, okay, great. I can't give you a specific answer. Here's what I would do based on XYZ scenarios. And you can talk to him about it. And I don't think that there's anything wrong with protecting and acknowledging your partner's feelings and that they are also now part of this equation.
No, I love that. I think that's a very respectful way to approach it. And I think cut down on some of the conflict too that can arise by sharing information if the other person finds out that you were talking about something they didn't want you to talk about.
It sure can.
Well, Erin, thank you so much for coming on and talking about these really awkward situations, but you do it in such a great way. I think it really ties back to the other books you've written and your style, and it's very approachable, very easy to get into and read and enjoy. So if everyone out there, if they're like, I want to hear more, I want to pick up this book, where do I go? What can I do? Because it launched on December 29th, and I'm sure people want to go check it out for themselves.
Well, you can get it wherever books are sold. I would encourage you, particularly in these pandemic times, to please support your local bookstores if that is available to you. Also to consider your local library. And for those who do happen to purchase a copy, please email proof of purchase to team@brokemillennial.com. And I have some goodies for you, including an exclusive bonus chapter, a prenup discussion guide, and an Are You Your Parents' Retirement Plan checklist. All you need to do is put in proof of purchase and put popcorn finance in the subject line to team@brokemillennial.com.
Oh, perfect. Well, thanks. Thanks for doing that for the listeners. And I'll make sure I put all of that in the show notes. That way you all can easily hop over there and get the book and then get these bonuses as well. And Erin, thank you so much. Really appreciate you hopping on and talking with me. I'm really excited for Broke Millennial Talks Money. And I think everyone should check it out. I think it's a great resource. And this is all training that we all need on how to be better about talking about money.
Well, and thanks for having me back. It is always a delight to be here.
Your boy keep it poppin' like Mary Poppins.